The Cyber Showdown event is live right now, bringing a whole lot of new stuff, guys. We're talking about the store updates, new multiplayer plays, new customization, new event pass as well. So let's just jump in and check out what's new with the game. So let's check out the multiplayer. What will you be playing? You'll be playing the new mode of Attrition. Attrition is a limited life team slayer mode where you're able to revive your teammates. As I've mentioned in previous videos, we did see this game mode in the season one trailer as well. We have a new event pass for the Cyber Showdown as well, which looks pretty dang good, to be honest. We got a new stance here. It's not filled with like challenge swaps or XP boosts, none of that stuff. It's actual like content, stuff you can customize your stuff with in the game. So you got a stance right here, then you have an assault rifle coating right here, which is kind of like a cool like magenta pink kind of black color to the whole thing. Looks sweet. Emblem background, a new another emblem background. You have a cool visor kind of hologram thing in front of that. You have a new armor coating, which kind of matches that assault rifle. You have here a weapon charm, a new visor that's green, a orangey hunter blood, if that's what, if you want to call it, for one of the AIs. And for the final tier, you get the cool like highlighted mohawk kind of deal going on with this whole thing right here, which honestly, it's pretty sweet for some free customization. So how will you be unlocking all these different items? It's not like the Winter Contingency. You'll have to actually complete challenges. And all these challenges will be completed within the Attrition game mode. So for example, I've killed enemy Spartans behind with a melee attack, get one of those. Kill enemy Spartans in Attrition, 7 of those. Kill enemy Spartans with a melee in Attrition, do that 10 times. Kill enemy Spartans with an assault rifle, do that 5 times. All this within Attrition, and then complete Attrition matches, just one right there. So you kind of get the idea. All ended up with the rampant visor attachment for the weekly ultimate. But the big one I'm sure you guys were curious about is the store. How's that changing? Well, let's go check it out. Because if you remember, Jerry Hook said that they're doing massive cuts and changes to the store here. So let's check it out. And the prices have certainly dropped. The bundle right here being $10, another bundle being $12 for USD. That's way different than $20 and $15. So if you count this bundle right here as a replacement for the $20 bundle, this is a 40% reduction. So pretty fair right there. And for the Neon B, if you consider this one like the $15 one that we had previously, this is a 66% reduction in price. But what's the content in there? Well, for $10 for the Neon B, you do get the spawning armor effect right here, as well as some other kind of cool stuff. Same thing to like the fire effect you had for the battle pass, but it's some kind of like a Cyber Showdown kind of effect. You have another visor, and then you have some emblems right here as well, all that. So basically the spawn effect and the visor for $10, which I think for just those two items is a little bit on the steep side of things, but certainly a step in the right direction. Though the Neon Superfly might grab my buck here, guys, because you get the Yoroi coating, you do get the Mark 7 coating, you have a new visor as well, which really stands out, it was pretty cool. You have a weapon coating for the assault rifle, which does look pretty awesome, not gonna lie. You also have a battle rifle coating, you have an epic vehicle coating for the Wasp right here, which that just looks slick right there. And all this again for $10, for $12 here on this one, guys. You also get a coating for your Warthog, you get another coating here for your Razorback, another coating here for your Rocket Hog, and you also get another stance as well. I have a feeling you're gonna be seeing this bundle around a lot. We also have the Zodiac River bundle as well, which does create some pretty unique customization as well. Look, this is a pretty outlandish coating, but honestly, it's kind of fun and looks kind of cool in my opinion. So it changes the color, right? But you also have new wheels. We haven't had this kind of customization yet. So it's something visually different to your Warthog that you can see while you're playing, which is kind of cool. Same kind of coating for your Razorback, and another coating here for your Rocket Hog as well. And for $5, we have the Keep It Clean bundle. This is for the daily bundle. This, I think, about stayed right about the same right here. You get another green colored AI right here. But you also have the Superintendent emblem. I know a lot of people are really big fans of the Superintendent from ODST, so you might actually just see a few people walking around with that. And also your challenge boost, XP boost are still $2. But overall, like right here, guys, like this is an improvement, a big improvement right here. Now, what I prefer, they used to be like no microtransactions and you get to earn everything through gameplay. Obviously, yes, but that's kind of how things are right now with gaming. And keep in mind that 343 did state that they're gonna be trying out different things, different kind of bundles, different prices and things like that within the game. And as soon as we get those changes revealed, I'll let you guys know here on the channel. But if you're new to the channel or missing any content, if you recently check out this playlist right here, I'm gonna link to all my Halo Infinite news and informational videos right there. Thanks so much for watching, greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.